Hello everyone, Suzy Gaming here, and welcome back to War Thunder. Today we're in dev server and we're gonna check out the new stuff that's coming with the new update, which is called Direct Hit. So why is it called Direct Hit? I believe because of this plane, MiG-27M, located at the right side of the tech tree, comes with the Mavericks. Russian Mavericks, let's say. And also with the smart bombs. Let's check out the modification tree, get ready for this. Look how crowded it is. So here are the new things, KH-29T and CAP-500. So basically our plane is gonna laser the target and missile will follow it. First I'm gonna try the bomb. You can combine them with the air-to-air missile loadout. By the way, if you wanna lock with this bomb, you need to set a key for it. It's called lock guided bombs. Whatever is empty for now. If you fly high and fast, you can drop it from 10 kilometers. But enemy will not stand on its own place and accuracy of this bomb is questionable, so forget about it. Not sure if I'm gonna use this bomb in the matches. I mean, you can do this easily with the normal ballistic computer. Do you even need a smart bomb? Now we're gonna try the missiles. We can pick two of them. This is how it looks. Works just like that. There's the MiG-27. Now let's check out the Swedish jet. Nothing unique about the armament. It's just looking cool. That gives it modern look. It looks like a Eurofighter. We also receiving the premium Draken in the next update. Let's look at its modifications. Bit weaker armament. And it looks like this, just white, silverish. This plane can go backward, as you can see. Let's see if I can fly like this. It will be hilarious if I can. Okay, this is critical speed, kind of, I think. How am I even gonna control this? Oh god, oh no, 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 no. Oh, kind of. I cannot control them. Yes. Yep, it's possible. Okay. Just a bit, I fly it. You know what, I'm gonna take off, slow down in midair. Sounds like P90 or something, submachine gun. Okay, now I'm gonna stop. Thrust reversal on. And fly backwards. No, 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 no. The thing is, it pushes the nose down. So I don't know how to make this work, but yeah. Maybe it is possible. It also helps to slow down faster. There's our little air brake. Maybe if it's possible to glide, if there's like cliff at the end of the airfield, in one of the masks, but right now I don't want to deal with this. Sort of possible. Okay. And the last interesting vehicle we're gonna receive in the next update is the Type 87 RCV. 25mm of cannon with penetration 92. That's awesome for 7.3. Just a bit less than the Bradley's penetration, but more than the Soviet penetration. Speaking about BMPs, of course. 82, yeah. 10mm more penetration. It could be effective in some situations. But yeah, let's do not forget that this thing is 7.3, guys. One, two sets of smoke. Also new test map, if you noticed it. God, this thing is slow on the mud. Whoa. That's quite fast, whoa. Good vertical guidance. No thermal. Can we kill something sideways? 92 easily, I believe. A decent speed, eh? 4 cruising speed and on grassy terrain. Yeah, let's say 40 kph on grassy terrain. On the road, 50. So it looks like it's a 8.3 vehicle, you know, like VMEA, Chinese VMEA or something. But yeah, 92mm of penetration. I'm curious how useful it's going to be. This thing can break the barrel really fast, so... yeah, that should be the first thing you need to do. Damn, that was fast. Awesome fire rate. Oh, reverse speed! The most important thing. 19, okay. Not that impressive. Trust me, the rest of the vehicles are just copy-paste, you know, classic Gaijin. For example, check out this Abrams. I mean, there's already 5 tanks that is similar to Abrams. They done the same thing to the Shermans. Look how many Shermans in the game. I can't wait to get 2 more Abrams. It will be a really unique gameplay, I'm pretty sure. We need more Abrams. I'm always against this duplicate tanks. As long as there is no big change, there should not be new models. And guess what? Another murder. Same gun, only with thermal. Copy paste. Vickers, we have Vickers. There it is. I'm not even going to test them. So a bit more chunkier turret from the front. We still have the ammo pack here. Classic Vickers. Vickers is an amazing tank, by the way. At 7.7, it's one of my favorites. I even have a video about it. It's at the right top corner. Click it. What will be special about this tank? It seems it has more engine power, much more maneuverable. Another copy-paste vehicle, ZTZ-99. And there's also this new thing at the X-ray. When you look at the modern jet and aim the cursor at the pilot, it will show up what are the computer-assisted aiming modes you have. So, cannon sight, rocket sight, bomb sight, and models as well. It gives a detailed information. Another unique thing for the ships, Kurel plays ships. For the ships we have some sort of new aiming mechanics. Honestly, I'm not interested about it. But yeah, if there's any ship players there, that's a thing. YA some sort of H64 model, maybe prototype model. Here's the ornament of it. Not that rich, but it's at the 10.0 of PR. Looks like this. We also have this box 3.0. We have 42 millimeters of penetration. Not that fast, but it will be a Chungus R3 basically. If you're gonna get down tier 2.0, maybe you can pan sideways. Like, this is a decent autocannon. Even though cannon looks really modern, we don't have stabilizer. Okay. Okay. T-34. Now if we cannot kill T-34 frontally, I think we'll be screwed. If we play against like Germans, I think this thing can do something. But yeah, against Russians, sloped armor, hell no. They changed the sounds of the autocannons, by the way. 7.0 Italian, there it is, left branch, 7.0. And looks like copy-paste, they just stick the oval cannon to it, to a different hole. Nothing interesting about it, I mean, you got the idea. We also have Russian box, another copy-paste. So when developers were showcasing this vehicle, they said it can swim. Who the hell wants a swimming tank? Who the hell wants to swim anyways? Nobody knows. After how many years, we finally have a different camouflage. That's right. Bush lovers, gather up, folks. Gather up. Let's cover this bad boy with the new bushes. So these are the old ones. Let's see. Banana leaves. Slam. Pine branches. What is this? Olive branches? Are these new ones? Big. The tank already looks like a vegetarian dish. Bunch of straw. I mean, these are quite big ones. Holy fucking shit. But look how colorful it is. At least it covers the armor completely. Like, there is no leaks. So it could protect from thermal. And this one, Autumn Tree. This one a bit worse. Yeah. Check this out. Like, much bigger coverage, right? New map, of course. Oh, I'm gonna... Oh, shit. Okay. Oh, nice. Leave the queue timer. Finally, they fixed it. Because before, if you cancel the queue, it will still put you to the match. It was quite annoying. Yeah, this is the map, just to showcase. I mean, you probably remember it. There should be one more new map they're adding, but I don't know the name. Like, when I play with this, if there is a IS-2 in front of me, I'll probably be dead. So that's why I need to break the barrels. And hope I can survive from the Dishkas or 50 cals. This thing doesn't have armor, right? Yeah. Hull armor 10 millimeters. Great. By the way, this is the spot where you can hide from the bombers. The roof cannot be destroyed. I think this will be the perfect spot. Like, look, there's even a wall here. You can protect yourself from the tanks. I think that's it. There's nothing else to show. Have a good day, and I'll see you next time. Bye.